In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let me bless your day with this daily gospel reflection. The gospel passage for our reflection is taken from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 1, 26 to 38. Today we celebrate the fourth Sunday of the Advent. Does the proclamation of the gospel message fill you with joy and hope? When God made a covenant with David as king over Israel, he made a promise to David and to his descendants that David's dynasty would endure forever through the coming of the Messiah. The king would establish an everlasting kingdom of peace and security for his people. We often think of peace as the absence of trouble. The peace which the Messiah brings cancels the debt of sin and restores our broken relationship with God, our Heavenly Father. We see the fulfillment of God's unfolding plan of redemption in the events leading up to the incarnation, the birth of the Messiah. The new era of salvation begins with the miraculous conception of Jesus in the womb of Mary. This child to be born is conceived by the gracious action of the Holy Spirit upon Mary, who finds favor with God. This child will be great and son of the Most High and King, and his name shall be called Jesus, which means the Lord saves. He will save his people from their sins. The angel repeats to Mary, the daughter of the house of David, the promise made to King David. The Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. How does Mary respond to the words of God delivered by the angel Gabriel? She knows she is hearing something beyond human capacity. It will surely take a miracle which surpasses all that God has done previously. Her question, "How shall this be since I have no husband?" is not prompted by doubt or skepticism, but by wonderment. She is a true hearer of the word, and she immediately responds with faith and trust. Mary's prompt response of heirs to the divine message is a model of faith for all believers. Mary believed God's promises even when they seemed impossible. She was full of grace because she trusted that what God said was true and would be fulfilled. She was willing and eager to do God's will, even if it seems difficult or costly. Mary is the mother of God because God becomes incarnate when he takes on flesh in her womb. What is the key that unlocks the power and grace of God's kingdom in our personal lives? Faith and obedience, for sure. God gives us grace and he accepts us to respond with the same willing obedience and heartfelt trust as Mary did. When God commands, he also gives the help and means to respond. We can either yield to his grace or resist and go our own way. Do you believe in God's promises, and do you yield to his grace? Heavenly Father, you offer us abundant grace, mercy, and forgiveness through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Help us to live a grace-filled life as Mary did by believing in your promises and by giving you our unconditional yes to your will and plan for our life. And may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.